This one's for all the marbles, Randy. This one is for third place in the Western Region and a ticket to Hotlanta.
Hotlanta!
WFTDA Championships.
Now, I do want to address something. There was a little bit of controversy yesterday with the Rose City bout. I had called the bout for Oli with about 5 minutes, 50 points in a power jam left, and there was a strong reaction at back home in Portland. Due to that, so I would just like to say that I'm calling it for Rose City right now. Rose City's already going to Hotlanta. They already made it just for you fans in Portland. The game doesn't even have to happen. Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. I just remembered I'm a sportscaster and not a mascot. Just remember that. Sorry about
that. Even though you've got the horns and you have remnants of your mascot days.
There's so many angry tweets coming from Bay Area fans all of a sudden. What's that about? Oh, my goodness. I'm seeing so much stuff. Anyway.
Speaking of tweets, you can tweet, talk to WFTDA, as you see it there, held by my fabulous nailed hand. And you can talk directly to us, and we may read your tweets, and we may not.
More importantly, you can talk to Moxie and find out how she got her nails done, where she went, you know, her process, how much she paid for it. That stuff's important.
I don't give away those kind of secrets, Randy.
She fancy. You fancy.
No, I got the bling.
Mm-hmm. I got the whatever that is.
It's a puka shell necklace.
Yeah, it's whatever is tearing the neck out of my neck is what it is. So let's talk about these two teams this weekend. Rose City, penalties being a very big issue with them. They won against Angel City, but it was a lot closer than people anticipated due to turns for the penalty box.
About a 50-point game, right, Randy?
Yeah, exactly. And then with Oli, came in very, very close score, two-point bout, but penalties became a big issue for them.
Bay Area as well had problems with their penalties. In the bout last night against the Denver Roller Dolls, they were up 50 points at the half and then kept going to the box, and ended up losing by 20 points. So both of these teams really fighting for that third place spot and that ticket to Nationals.
I had a great talk with G Money before the bout, and he was talking about, with this bout, I don't want any jammers to go to the penalty box. I don't want this bout decided by power jams. I want it by two teams playing their hearts out and rolling the dice with it, and I thought that was great. That's a great game. I'm just going to go throw down for that. That's an amazing game.
She is super awesome. We should hang out with her sometime.
We're going to party tonight. Anyway, yeah, so I'm looking forward to both these teams because they're so good, such good teams, such high execution players on both sides, such deep benches. I think we're set up for a really exciting battle.
I think we are too, Randy. I am going to bite these fabulous nails right off my hands tonight.
Well, you save them. I'm going to sell them on eBay. All right, so... Sulfuric acid stepping up to the line, jamming for the Rose City Wheels of Justice.
And skater 26, Chantilly Mace, jamming for Bay Area.
Neither one a shocker as far as starting off this bout.
No, I think that's a pretty standard jammer rotation. They're both those fearless jammers, the clutch jammers that you put out. They don't get those first jam jitters.
Yeah. You know? Like I do. Oh, my goodness.
I get entire bout jitters.
Yeah.
That's why I'm not out there skating.
It's just one giant jitter. All right. Cut track to get this party started. Demand a riot. Cutting outside. One danger of the scrum start is it's easy to cut. Sulfuric acid jumps around. Lead jammer, Rose City.
And Chantilly Mace with a wall of two Rose City blockers. She does get through, and she's not lead jammer. About a half a lap behind Sulfuric Acid, about to start her scoring pass.
Probably hit it and quit it. Brawling Angel escorts Sulfuric Acid to the outside, and that's going to be no point, 0-0 on that first jam. How exciting, Ms. Moxie.
I'm excited. I'm having a great time. We got any tweets over there? Remember, talk to WFTDA. You can chat directly with us. In the meantime, I'd like to let you know that Rydell is the official skate of the WFTDA. Unmatched quality and unmatched performance from Rydell Skates.
We got watchers from Edmonton, Alberta, Canada. Port Scandalous. Jay Cody says, this is going to be great. You're smart. Rad City also excited about this bout.
Knock, knock, number 32, jamming for Bay Area. She does pick up lead jammer, White Flight. Wheeling and dealing her way through that pack. She has Liza Machete, number one, left to pass, and joined by Shannon Dorado there in the front. They're going to have to let her go on that out of play.
Knock Knock already on her scoring pass. Rose City walled up all together to try to protect those points. It looks like Liza Machete going in for some offensive assistance there, Miss Moxie.
Yeah, she is trying to make a hole in that real strong Rose City wall. Knock Knock picking up the first 3 points of the game for Bay Area.
Knock Knock had an incredible bout last night. She had lead jammer and I believe all but 2 jams.
You are
last
correct.
Night.
She told me that herself after the game. She was very proud of that, as she should be.
I had lead jammer and all but 2 jams.
Something like that, yeah.
Well, and it was a very different game for her from the night before when they played Rat City, and she went to the box 3 consecutive jams in a row. So yeah. I think she was pretty stoked on
it. It was a good changeup. I thought she took their game in the right direction there. Skull Eagle up at the line for Rose City.
And fan favorite number 21, Lulu Lockjaw, jamming for Bay Area.
On the inside, Skull Eagle takes lead jammer for Rose City.
And Lulu Lockjaw out just about half a lap behind again.
All right, Rose City going into an offensive formation, tried to get some points for Skull to make. She muscles through, calls off the jam. 4.
4 points.
Already a 1 point game, Miss Moxie.
Well, we predicted a close game between Rat City and Bay Area, rightfully so, and it was. And I think, you know, provided both of these teams can stay on the floor, I think we're set up for here another super close game.
We smart.
We know things.
We know things like Sulfuric Acid's back on the line for Wheels of Justice.
And that's Easy Breezy Beautiful, number 500, Ivy Profane, jamming for Bay Area. She's around the outside, and she's going to take a cut track major, I think.
I think it was a minor.
Oh,
she got hit out, but it was only past 1 opposing player, so that's only a minor.
Okay.
Meanwhile, Sulfuric Acid quickly makes lead jammer by navigating the front wall.
She is fast.
She's pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
Kick Acid, he's 1 left to beat for Ivy Profane, but Sulfuric Acid is navigating that wall.
And it looks like there is a Rose City skater, number 81, Havana Goodtime, going to take a minute in the box for an out-of-play major. Meanwhile, back at the ranch, 3 points picked up by Sulfuric Acid and the Wheels of Justice.
I got to talk about this ref crew really quick. Watching the exciting Sacred City, Angel City bout earlier, this was the ref crew, and as exciting as the bout was, this is one of the best called bouts I think I've ever seen.
Ever seen in my life.
Solid. The entire ref crew, it was so on top of that.
It was
incredible to watch.
I've been talking all weekend about how great the refs are. And Mr. Rock, I just got to give the guy a shout out. He has 18 pairs of eyes. He sees everything. He's all knowing.
For instance, he knows that White Flight is jamming 4 Wheels of Justice.
And he can probably see Chantilly Mace out there. Not picking up lead jammer, but she is out in the lead.
Minor cut prevents Chantilly Mace from getting it. White Flight is lead. Looks like killing some time off the Havana Goodtime penalty clock.
And she called it a little bit too late there. Chantilly Mace able to pick up 2 points on that pass.
Nickels and dimes. She disagrees, I think we can see at the bench.
She does disagree.
Yeah. I don't know.
Do you think they know we can see them, Randy?
We'll find out.
This will be fun. Yes.
Oh, my gosh. Knock, Knock, and Scald Eagle on the line together? Are you kidding me?
We're ready for a rumble. Only 2 blockers on the track. Number 73 for Rose City there, Frankenherter, incidentally. Just starting with Rose City this year, she came off a couple years with the Bay Area All-Star team. So she is playing her old team for the first time tonight.
I think there's adjustment to the score because of a penalty box point, and there might have been a change around. I know Mercy stepped in. I don't know if it's because she picked up a penalty and now she has to clear it. I'm not sure. We'll find out if she goes straight to the penalty box or not.
I am looking at Mercy here on the screen, and I can see the little wheels on her, or the wings on her socks. She is fast, but Knock Knock is faster. She picks up lead jammer for Bay Area.
That is confirmed, by the way, about the box point penalty at the end of the jam.
All right. Not to be upstaged, Skald Eagle gets out, starts her scoring run, but Knock Knock able to pick up 3 points before she calls off the jam just in time.
Change number one there. 9-7, Bay Area Rose City.
Still at the single digits here with 6 minutes into the game. Well, serious defense, Randy. Serious defense.
Already, penalties already being an issue for Rose City as they're going into this at a 2-4 disadvantage.
And I know her by her stance. That's Lulu Lockjaw, number 21. I can't see her head, so that must be Lulu Lockjaw on the line for Bay Area.
Sophia Gassi definitely jamming for Rose City. Wheels of Justice somehow navigates the inside despite the blocker disadvantage and takes lead jammer, Miss Moxie.
Yeah, Lulu Lockjaw going to the box on a low block major. She's going to sit for a minute, and this is going to be a power jam for Rose City.
Well, this is the first power jam so far, but Bay Area at a huge blocker advantage. Mel Mangles and Havana Goodtime trying to trap one off. Sophia Gassi gets through, 5 points, calls the jam, not sure why. I don't know if she knew she was a power jam. I don't know if she wanted
to. I think maybe she just wanted to get a fresh jammer out there. I mean, she did only have two blockers on the track, so if I were her, I might have run the clock a little bit more, but she knows what she's doing. She's one of those jammers that is very present when she skates, you know, really pays attention to what's going on.
This will start off power jam, but again, we have to. The time goes to that initial pass there, and the 4-2 blocker advantage for Bay Area.
White Flight can get through this, and it looks like she's working on it.
Ooh, big hit shrugged off there from Brawlin' Angel, lead jammer. White Flight! We have some reinforcements in for Rose City.
I hear whistles. Somebody's going to the box.
It's French Tickler with a back block right there. So it's back to a 4-2 advantage. But White Flight is on her scoring pass.
Bell Right Hook sending her to the inside, denying her passage.
Mercy setting up an offensive screen. So a White Flight is collecting points right now.
Has yet to clear the pack.
Wow, great offensive hit by Frankenherter on number 7 there, opening up a 5-point pass.
Lulu Lockjaw out of the box, onto the track. Her initial pass, she's not lead jammer. And it looks like we have Murder in Monroe going to the box. I did not see the call on that one, but that is going to start this jam.
Two more points there for Rose City, able to capitalize. That was a cut track major for Murder in Monroe. Rose City 19, Bay Area 9, a 10-point lead. Mostly coming from the power jam right there, Miss Moxie.
Yeah, it looks like Ivy Profane is going to try and close that gap a little bit. She's going to be jamming against Scald Eagle for Rose City.
We're 3-3 in the pack, so even odds as we go into this.
And it looks like Scald Eagle going to play a little jammer on jammer D, help her blocker secure Ivy Profane before she makes her own attempt. Not successful, though. Ivy is out and lead jammer for Bay Area.
She had a nice inside wall, inside lane opened up for her. Good opportunity. Jump to the inside for Scald Eagle, her initial pass.
Ivy Profane scoring points. Quickly.
Heidi goes seek last line of defense. She gets by her, calls it 4 points. Bay Area 13, Rose City 19.
And you know, Randy, we're wearing headphones, so it's not quite so loud, but I happen to know that the Bay Area fan base in here makes this place incredibly noisy when something good happens for the ladies in gold.
That's weird.
I know, it's pretty crazy.
That's some of that hometown advantage I've heard about. All right, and if you want an advantage when you're on the track, check out RideLSkates.com, the official skate of the WFTDA. Unmatched quality, unmatched performance.
RideL.
All right, sulfuric acid up against two more Bay Area blockers there.
Chantilly Mace jamming for Bay Area.
Looks like sulfuric acid got it, lead jammer, but was cycled to the pack.
And Chantilly Mace is out and able to score, but something tells me that sulfuric acid is not going to let that happen.
Just in the nick of time, 0-0.
Like we can read their minds. These girls are so smart.
They know.
We can tell what they're going to do. They're doing what they should be doing. They're executing out there on the track, Randy.
Isn't that a good time?
I know, it's crazy.
I hope you're having fun out there, ladies and gentlemen.
Green Monster, makers of Antic, Cumball, Toe Stops, Heartless Wheels, Reckless Wheels, and Moto Bearings. Green Monster doesn't just give you great derby products. They give you confidence. Gernmunster der Kerm.
I'm a Gernmunster. I fight. It's mine. It's a duster.
Knock, knock. Gold Star, number 32.
Well, Bay Area have cleared their penalty box, so they have an advantage. So they're going to get this jam started.
They're going to attempt to get this jam started. Liza Machete's like, guys, hey, guys. Hey, guys, what's happening, guys?
I wish we had a shot of G-Money going,
knock, knock through with a quick lead jammer due to that blocker advantage. But White Flight, whoa, tripping over, I think, J.K. Rowling there, her own teammate.
Yeah. You can't get a misconduct for engaging your own skater. And so White Flight is going defense, finds an opening.
Good
in the
call there by White Flight.
It's going to give her a chance to at least stop the bleeding and reduce this to one scoring pass.
Looks like 4 points.
Five points.
Five in the sky for Knock Knock in Bay Area. We have a 1 point game. Uno.
Rob Lobster is confirming the fifth point. It is confirmed. I believe Knock Knock did hit the pack and get the point on Whitey
before Whitey got out.
Yep. So
she caught up to her, and then Whitey took off again. So, again, because I can't see her, I know that's number 21 Lulu Lockjaw jamming for Bay Area.
And because she's really tall, I know that Scald Eagle is her lead jammer.
Scald Eagle is lead jammer Lulu Lockjaw, hoping to catch her a little bit here.
All right, she gets out, so there's probably going to be one scoring pass opportunity for Rose City. Their penalty box is clear here, so it's an option to get something.
Pack is quite fast.
You know, it's hard to mess with that Bay Area defense there. 0-1 for Bay Area on that.
Lulu squoze out a point there. Tie game, 19-19.
Rose City already with 6 minutes in penalty backs. Bay Area only two. Now, last night, Bay Area skated an incredibly clean first period.
Yeah, they did.
They know how to stay on the track. Things went a little different the second period.
Yeah. You can say that again, Randy.
But Rose City really need to concentrate on staying on the track here to not give up as many points as Denver did.
And they do have a blocker advantage right now. There's four on the floor for Rose City, only three for Bay Area, and we have a lead jammer, sulfuric acid.
No mangles and... is that Untamed Shrew? Yes, Untamed Shrew. Last line is a defense for Ibuprofen. Mel Mingles trying to escort Ivy to the outside.
And instead, number 52, Kid Ace, is going to escort sulfuric acid to the outside.
I was like, that's a good idea. I'm going to try that. Sulfuric acid jukes around Kid Ace there. Goes on a scoring pass. Checks with the bench. Calls off the jam. Four more points.
Just to make sure everything is copacetic. It's always smart for a jammer to look at her bench before she calls it off, because who knows, somebody may have gone to the box.
We got people all over watching here tonight.
Ventura County tweeting in. Hi, Ventura County. Hey. And Toronto Derby.
I believe that was a team timeout called by Rose City there. Don't know why.
We will know by the blinking. No, it looks like they're giving it to Bay Area.
Oh, timeout. Sorry.
Yeah.
I apologize.
At least that's what the scoreboard says.
We'll see about where that goes.
I'm not quite sure what they're talking about, but I know that I can talk about Iron Doll Clothing.
Sure can.
Custom uniforms for the modern roller girl and referee. They've been lifting and separating since 2009. Check them out at irondollclothing.com.
We appreciate it. Here's the pass by, or the hit out by Kid Ace on Sulfuric Acid. Beautiful hit.
I love the instant replay. It's like my favorite thing in the world, Randy.
Thanks to good people at Blaze Streaming Media for making it all so fancy. Thank you, guys. I'm looking at you. They're ignoring me.
And they're tired of listening to us, Randy.
Yeah,
unlike you out there in WFDA.TV land, you love listening to me and Randy Pan.
Or at least Moxie.
We like to think so. Anyway.
We do. All right. We're going to get this party started.
And that's the jam. Chantilly Mace jamming for Bay Area against Scald Eagle for Rose City. Mace up front, but it's going to be Scald Eagle, I think, that picks up your lead jammer.
Outside pass there. She gets a pass. Chantilly Mace, who is tied up with Mercy.
Yeah, it looks like there was a pass, no penalty there for Chantilly Mace. She wasn't lead jammer, but she did pick up a minor on her way there. So I think a fourth minor is going to send that Rose City blocker to the box. We also have number 170 Sugar Pusher going to the box for Bay Area.
Calls off the jam with 3 points there as she takes a spill there. Rose City 26, Bay Area 19. I got to say, this is a very different Rose City than we've seen in the last 2 days. You see a much clearer headspace, a little bit of penalty trouble, but they're not letting it affect their gameplay right now.
Absolutely.
It looks like they're having fun, dare I say.
Yeah. They might be. They may be.
That would be bananas.
You know, this is serious business out here on the track. Like I said earlier, this is for a ticket to championships, but
Moxie,
above all, these girls play to have fun.
Let's get serious about having some fun.
I don't like to be serious, Randy. I like to have a good time. Number 32, Knock Knock, also likes to have a good time. She is jamming for Bay Area.
Get cycled to the back of the pack there, and Sulfuric Acid is your lead jammer.
It looks like Knock Knock ran into Demanda Riot on her way through the pack. She is out about a half lap behind Sulfuric Acid.
Demanda Riot, such a good blocker. She'll block any jammer. She doesn't care whose team she is. Oh!
Speaking of which, Demanda Riot sends Sulfuric Acid to the inside, forcing her to call off the jam. Did she pick up any points on her way through that pass?
Or a penalty. I think there's some review going on there. 2 points picked up by Acid. Rob is like, what's happening? What's happening? I got opinions. I want to talk to you. What's going on?
You know, I think the coaches for Bay Area and Rose City have that in common.
I love them both so much.
I do too. They actually are pretty good friends off track, honestly. They like to talk derby and strategy and all that good stuff. Coach G Money and Coach Rob Lobster. But right now, they are vicious enemies.
Mortal enemies.
That's what I meant.
Scald Eagle inside pass around Bell. Right hooks lead jammer Rose City.
And Lulu Lockjaw jamming for Bay Area with one Rose City blocker left to pass.
Scrappy Go Lucky.
Now
she
three.
Catches her with Kickacity and White Fly in a blocking position, Miss Moxie.
All right, Lulu is out.
Liza Machete trying to pick off Mel Mangles. Wow, fancy pass inside to the outside. 4 points, Scarlet Eagle calls it. 32-19, Rose City.
Like we said, Randy, nickel and diming, and that lead jammer status is becoming more and more important because we are seeing both jammers get out of the pack, but really the only one that's scoring is the one that gets out first.
What's also important to this bout are the wheels, probably specifically the Radar Villain wheels, because they are tired of sliding through those slippery corners. And you notice they're not doing it.
They're not.
It might be the Radars.
Maybe.
Just saying.
Number 500, Ivy Profane jamming for Bay Area. And it looks like Sulfuric Acid again with a star out and lead jammer. She's very good at getting that lead jammer nod.
She's been very consistent with it so far tonight. Heidi Goes Seek and J.K. Rowling, last line of defense on Ivy Profane there. Miss Moxie.
Yeah,
now Mercy.
Mercy has been deadly all weekend long.
Mercy.
I am terrified of her. Can I just tell you that?
You
terrified.
Should be. Oh, around the outside. Five the hard way. Well, no, let's check it out. Five the hard way there. Sulfuric Acid with a grand slam. Five the hard way refers to when all five skaters on the track and the jammer gets by them all.
And Bay Area trying to play a little bit of offense here, but not having a whole lot of luck getting Ivy out and instead getting tripped up. They are able to play some defense. Demanda Riot sending Sulfuric Acid to the back of the pack, thus springing Ivy Profane. She's out. She's not lead, but Sulfuric Acid is still scoring.
Sulfuric Acid does get out the one last pass there. Calls off the jam. 5 more points there on that. Ladies and gentlemen out there, if you have some favorites out there, check out WFTDA.com/MVP. You can vote for your favorite jammer, your favorite blocker. I'd like to make a nomination for your favorite blocker.
Nomination. Yeah.
Colonel Skirts, number 777 for Wasatch. Oh, my goodness.
Dude.
She was bananas.
Bananas. I agree. Their whole team is so impressive. Like, they kind of came out of nowhere. You know, they came in the first regional tournament for them for Wasatch this weekend, and they blew minds. They are amazing.
Yeah, she herself, great offense, defense. And Chantilly Mays with lead jammer.
First lead jammer for Bay Area in quite a few jams, Randy.
It's been a while, but what's happened is we've gone to, well, not an advantage, but Bay Area 3-3 in the pack. Cut major on Liza Machete, I believe.
Yeah, she's not going to be happy about that.
She doesn't like ref calls.
She doesn't like ref calls, especially when they're against her. Chantilly Mays picking up all 4 points.
Check out the awareness. Check out her looking in on G-Money to time the call off.
Yes, and did you see Slavia Majora come out of the box and run like her butt was on fire away from White Flight because she didn't want to be a point. These girls are constantly aware of what's going on. I'm so impressed. All right, so this was the first jam in the last six jams that Bay Area has scored. So they had six jams with no points until that last one. So really need to start putting some points on the board. 42 for Rose City, 23 for Bay Area. Hometown crowd, and Knock Knock is not going to be putting points on the board because she's going to the box for a back block major.
It's another power jam for Rose City there. Scald Eagle makes it through for her initial pass. She is lead jammer.
And she's a great person to have out there when you're on a power jam.
It helps.
She's quick. She's agile. She's really hard to move. I mean, she is so strong.
Those Rose City blockers trying to slow down the pack. They're Scrappy Go Lucky, Kickacity, and Mel Mangles. They pick off Brawling Angel as their coat. Bold.
But I mean, you know, take what you can get. They're trying to do that.
Mel Mangles picked up, I don't know if that was a back block or a direction. I did not see the call, I'm afraid.
It looks like Brawling Angel sending Scald Eagle to the inside, and then Scald's going to re-enter behind her. And
French Tickler picking up a multiplayer block, and that's been called a lot, especially on Rose City in the last couple days, so they need to be careful about that. Rose City with 7 minutes in the penalty box. Bad catching up with five.
Yeah, and it looks like Bay Area now with a full contingent of blockers. They are giving Scald Eagle a run for her money.
It's a fourth minor for Brawling Angel. She picked up a minor direction of play.
I just shouldn't ever say that. I just jinxed them, didn't I? I said they had all four on the floor, and then BA went to the box.
Well, they got all one jammer back on the floor as Knock Knock returns. Initial pass, no points yet there, Miss Moxie.
No, but she did come screaming through that pack. Chrissy Yamagata trying to take Scald Eagle to the outside, but again, Scald is very hard to move. And all right, one more grand slam for Scald Eagle in Rose City. 52 points for Rose, 23 for Bay Area. It seemed like maybe Knock Knock had enough time to score there, but no points were given to Bay Area on that scoring pass.
Well, Bay Area is coming into this next jam with a 3-2 blocker advantage. Now, Bay Area was doing a good job with the consistent scoring and the jammer at an advantage, so this might help them out here. We got J.K. Rowland and Mercy in the front wall, which I'd put him out there.
Heck yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
White Flight
makes it around the outside despite the blocker disadvantage. Lee Jammer, Rose City.
White Flight does not need a whole lot of help getting through that pack. She can do it her own dang self. Lulu Lockjaw, however, does need a little help from her blockers.
And she's gets it in the form of Bell Wright Hooks, opening up the inside and taking down Mercy, which is not easy.
Not easy, no. Bell has been on fire all weekend. I'm really impressed with Bell. She would be my nomination for MVP blocker.
That's a good one. That's
she's
good.
Incredible. I'm a big fan.
I'm a big fan, too, man. In 4 years, may I say. That's, I believe, a team timeout called for Bay Area.
It looks like Rose City called that timeout.
All right. I'm just making that up.
Again,
I'm just going to flip a coin.
Somebody called the timeout.
They're checking out their own. Adam Wheels, a proud partner and official wheel of the WFTDA. Maybe they're looking at their printed graphics for leaks, printing, and promotional needs. Hit up printcographics.com.
As awesome as printcographics is, I kind of doubt that they're looking at that right now.
Jacksonville and Rodeo City are checking us out. George W. Tush, how you doing? I know you're listening, but not tweeting while driving because that would be dangerous. This is a good time, but it isn't worth your life.
Hi, Tush. I'm not wearing my party vest, but I brought it. I'll be wearing it tonight at the after party for you.
This is the first time in years I've been able to say that name without giggling at the end.
She's a good time, that Georgia W. Tush. Montreal Roller Derby.
What? We international. All right, so no reviews or any of that craziness. Just going to be a team timeout. Looks like I'm so glad that poodling is going to go away soon, Moxie.
I know.
Yeah. But that is Sylvia Gassett picking up her intentional fourth minor.
And we do have 3-on-3 in the pack. Number 500, Ivy Profane jamming for Bay Area. Neither team taking a knee, so.
Untrained Shrew up for the first time tonight, jamming for the Wheels of Justice.
Ivy Profane up front, one more blocker to pass. She will be your lead jammer. Kid Ace hanging on for dear life, trying to block. the Rose City Jammer.
Untamed Shrew. Yeah, the nice hammer-nail coordination there. Blast Unicorn trying to set up a screen, but it's used for Ivy Profane to get around there for a five-point Grand Slam, much needed by Bay Area at this time, Ms. Moxie.
It's true, and it looks like now we have a Untamed Shrew out, not lead jammer, Ivy Profane about to make a second scoring pass. Rose City running away from them.
Brolin Angel going in for some offense. Called. No packs called. 0-0 on that last pass.
All right. So 5 points for Bay Area. 28 for them and 56 for the Wheels of Justice.
6.5 minutes left. 3-3 blocker advantage for Bay Area. Scald Eagle is jamming for Bay Area. No, that would be crazy, wouldn't it? She's jamming
weird
for the Wheels of Justice. So I'm getting all these tweets from Portland fans right now. That's crazy. They're so angry.
Number 26, Chantilly Mace, jamming for Bay Area.
You're nice.
She's taking her time getting through that pack. She's trying to find a little weakness in that wall, but she's not having any luck.
It's going to be lead jammer, able to navigate the inside incredibly. Scald Eagle.
And Bay Area trying to play a little bit of offense for their girl, but
I'm going to play a game where I hold my breath as long as all 10 skaters are on the track and see if I die. I'm alive. I live.
And we have Bellwright Hooks being sent off for what I believe was an out of play major.
Yeah.
Called about a lap ago, but I don't think she heard it when it was called the first time.
Yeah. Quick pass through. That's going to be 4-4. Rosity.
Scald Eagle, I happen to know, broke her ankle at ECE this summer. Just three months ago, Andy?
Yeah.
She is a machine. She's not only back, but she's back in a big way.
She is part cyborg now, thanks to the surgery, a prototype of the RoboCop Terminator program.
Oh my gosh.
But, you know, they decided to go with a cheap version of it and start off with a roller derby skater. So she was game. I don't know if that matches the WFTDA rules.
Blocker advantage here for Bay Area. For Rose City. And we've got, it looks like, Slavia Majora being sent off. A couple skaters being sent off. But Knock Knock is going to be your lead jammer for Bay Area. White Flight being recycled to the back of the pack by Brawlin' Angel, one of only two Bay Area blockers out there. And we've got three for Rose City.
I want to confirm the Bellwright Hooks was blocking out of bounds on her last penalty. Not out of play.
Okay. So,
wow, knock, getting out of 5 points, muscling through Rose City there. We do have a 3-2, psych, 2-2. We have a diet pack, half the calories of a full pack.
And it looks like Knock Knock burning a little time for her blockers in the box. And it seems like both teams are kind of interested in doing that. So it's going to happen until somebody hits the pack. And
G-Money telling his blockers to push to speed. Knock Knock goes in for the jump. Did the hips pass? No. 0-0 on that pass. But time off the clock for the Bay Area penalty box.
For the whole penalty box, actually.
For all of them.
However, we are still going to start this with 2-on-2 in the pack. Lulu Lockjaw jamming for Bay Area and Sulfuric Acid.
Is that Lulu? She's not leaning down and we can see her head. Are you sure it's her?
It's crazy. Yes.
Oh, there it goes. Her head's disappeared. You can't even see it at home, ladies and gentlemen.
Nope, you can't. She's
can't even
hiding.
Confirm her number.
She's hiding
Where
behind Chrissy Yamagata.
Hide her. Mel also, like, no, we can't. All right.
We can't see her at all. We can only see her legs.
And they're not off.
Nope. The whistle has blown. Bellwright Hooks re-enters.
Hey, props to Rose City for, you know, going ahead and getting started, even at a disadvantage.
And it looks like Lulu Lockjaw is going to be your lead jammer for Bay Area.
Got to say, this is where Lulu Lockjaw does the most damage. When there is a pack advantage or a light pack, that's when Lulu Lockjaw does the best execution and puts points on the board.
And she had a little trip up there. It looks like number 52, Kid Ace, is going to sit in the box for a cut track major.
Yeah, all right. Now, Sulfuric Acid is still navigating on her initial pass here while Lulu Lockjaw is on her first scoring pass.
She's trying. She's dealing with two Rose City blockers up there.
Havana Good Time and Blast Unicorn.
And it looks like she does make her way through, picks up five in the sky, and Bay Area still barely managing to hang on to Sulfuric Acid until just now.
We call that a natural Grand Slam when it's a Grand Slam with the jammer still on.
It does feel very natural.
So natural. It's nature.
One more scoring pass for Bay Area. 4 points for Lulu. A much-needed 9 points there for Bay Area, bringing them to 42. Rose City with 60 points. Two minutes left to play in the first half.
How many points different is that, Miss Moxie?
Oh, my gosh. It's 18.
You were just studying just now.
Did you see my eyeballs crossing?
Like, I'd like to thank Iron Doll Clothing Custom Uniforms for the modern roller girl and referee lifting separating. Since 2009, Iron Dog Clothing.
I want to give a shout out to Roller Bones and Bones Bearings. They are always a winning combination, like me and Randy Pan.
It's because of our bearings. Gold Eagle on the line, navigating the back of the wall there.
But it's going to be Ivy Profane, I think, that gets that lead jammer nod.
Out of play called on
Frankenherder.
Frankenherder. She's like, whatever.
I guess I'm going to go to the box now.
All right, this is not what Rose City wants. If they start going to the penalty box, things like this happen.
Ivy Profane, 5 points for Bay Area. Scald Eagle still on her initial pass.
Yeah, it looks like she's going to D up a little bit and get with the wall here.
And she is so strong, Randy. She's one of those jammers that can totally do that and then just bust through the pack, no problem.
Is it an opportunity for her to hit people? She'll take it. Jukes around. Mel Mangles in the front. Another 5 points for Ivy Profane.
Shannon Dorado sending Scald Eagle again to the outside there in turn two.
A transplant from Denver. It looked like Shannon Dorado picked up a penalty. I did not see it, I'm afraid.
I did not either.
Trusty Brad Example is going to the boards. It was a fourth minor for Shannon Dorado.
Thank you, Brad Example.
All right, we've got some more points being scored here by Ivy.
Oh, finally an initial pass picked up. She saw her opportunity to take it there. This could stop the bleeding here, but in the meantime.
We've got five in the sky. We've got 57 on the board for Bay Area, 60 points for Rose City. Ivy burning the clock for her blockers in the box. She is going to call off the jam.
Well, we're going to start. Is there a timeout? No, we're going to let that go. So we're going to start the next jam with a 4-2 blocker advantage for Rose City and a 3-point advantage. What an exciting first period, Miss Moxie.
We called it.
We called it. We're so smart.
We just high-fived. I hope you guys high-fiving out there in WFTDA land. One more shout out. How about Fast Girl Skates?
How about it?
They are the first full-service brick-and-mortar derby store in the world. They bring their extensive in-store experience to you online. Fast Girl Skates knows firsthand how to make feet happy and skaters fast. Check them out at fastgirlskates.com.
I love me some of LeGrand Mort. How you doing out there, buddy? Miss you out here. Let's talk about that first period really quick. Now, Bay Area coming alive right away as Rose City picked up some penalties. Rose City cleaning up a little bit, able to execute and get a little run there.
Mm-hmm.
Back to the penalty box. Bay Area capitalizes big time.
Yeah, they're just kind of taking their turns there in the penalty box. And Randy, we know it. We've seen it. This second half is going to be dictated by how many skaters are on the floor.
Now, here's the thing. Late yesterday, what happened to both teams playing each other, both went serious heavy penalty trouble in the second period.
Yeah, so we'll
and they're,
see.
They're coming in even right now.
Yeah.
And it affected them both. So this halftime is going to be all about head game right
now. Resetting. They need to go in there, reset, kind of pat each other on the back, take a minute, and just, focus. Focus pants, calm, game face, maybe zen out a little bit there
Does
in the locker room.
Does Iron Doll Clothing make lift and separate focus pants? Because,
that might be something that they could look into.
That's some good stuff there. This has been a very exciting bout. Really looking forward to the second period. We're going to check into some words from our sponsors, and Team Pan and Moxie are going to go pass out. That is great for them. That is a great – this is this weekend. Bay Area's cleanest weekend I've ever seen, ever, in years.
I am also not used to seeing them this clean, Randy, I have to say. They're focused, and they really want this. So I feel like if they can stay on the floor for the second half, that's going to make a big difference.
It's going to make a huge difference. The only person in penalty trouble right now, French Tickler right now, sitting on 4 minutes in penalty box. It's a few more than you want going into the half.
Yeah, but I mean, it's manageable.
Yeah, it's manageable. For a bit, we have a bunny. and
we have this. We have hashtag #TalkToWFTDA. You can chat with us on Twitter. And you should also log on to WFTDA.com/MVP and vote for your MVPs of this tournament.
I have a jammer nomination.
Okay.
ACDG, Fifi Phenomenon.
Love her.
Wow.
I'm right there with you. High five.
Bananas.
High five.
Oh my gosh. She's
my fave.
You know, when she was in there with Chrissy Crash, just damage.
Forget it.
Oh,
forget
man.
It.
Yeah, she was. She lives. It's not just a clever name.
No, she's amazing. And yeah, ACDG is really lucky to have that girl.
I always throw down for Foreclosure, too. Just
oh,
always
yeah.
Just like Foreclosure forever.
Both. I mean, you know what?
Forever.
Randy, we have some incredible jammers here in the Western region.
We do.
Like mind-blowing.
Like blizzowing. We have incredible skaters. We have incredible teams. We have a really, really, really deep region. And that is the power and the tragedy of the West Region Tournament. You know, both of these teams could go in to champs and do some serious. The 5-6 seed,
well,
both of the teams can go in and
can
do
talk
some damage.
Real briefly here about Bay Area. Bay Area at the Star of Texas Bowl this summer took out the number one seeds from both North and South Centrals. Texas and Windy City beat both of those teams. So, you know, those are the number one seeds in two other regions.
And
they are here struggling for third place.
Rose City beat both teams this season, too.
All right. So,
you know what I mean?
Western region, incredibly tough division.
Exactly.
But it does make for some great derby.
And it makes these teams stronger.
Yes, it does.
They know they have to spend the year coming to compete for this. It really builds up the teams. It builds up Sophia Gassett, who's jamming for the Wheels of Justice.
And Chantilly Mace jamming for Bay Area. 3-on-2 blocker advantage for Rose City.
Oh, it looks like we have little bit of run there. Chantilly Mace going defensive, jamming on Sulfuric Acid there. I think that's a smart play on her part.
And I have to say, I don't normally see her do this.
Fourth minor picked up for Scrappy Go Lucky.
And Chantilly Mace is going to defy the odds and pick up lead jammer.
It looks like Kigacity for an offensive hit on Bell Wright. There's a statement I don't say too often, getting Sulfuric out on her initial pass.
Chantilly Mace, nobody touched her. She's got three blockers on the track. She's telling them to run. She wants to burn a little bit more time for her blockers in the box.
Lord Bunsen, Hoppy Doo, is saying hi to everybody. We had all kinds of people who were watching from all over, tweeting, and check it out.
We have a lead change. 61 points Bay Area, 60 points Rose City. Chantilly Mace with a full five there
on her
last pass.
Now, the first period, Sulfuric Acid had 7 of the 8 lead jams every time she was up. But this so far.
And, you know, Randy, you were talking about the Bay Area hugging in that last little close-up shot. Bay Area really likes each other.
They used to hate each other, but now it's all different.
No, I mean, we have never had the kind of cohesion that this team has this year. I mean, that's a major difference. Knock, knock, lead jammer, Bay Area.
Well, it seems to be working out for them as they are executing lead jammer. Two jams in a row there. White Flight trying to navigate, gets past Chrissy Yamagacha for her initial pass.
Knock, knock, trying to take the outside on Mercy and J.K. Rowling. Not having a whole lot of luck. Racing. Hanging on just barely. Wow! Some fancy footwork there by Knock Knock. Calls off the jam. 4 points Bay Area.
She good. Looked like a potential fourth niner was picked up by Scott Eagle in the meantime there. Penalties. 3-on-3 in the pack, Ms. Magday.
And I can't see your face, so I know it's Lulu Lockjaw jamming for Bay Area. I'm going to stop saying that.
You can't see her at home either.
And she's that's like, Sulfuric Acid jamming for the only two blockers on the floor, Rose City.
I like how Sulfuric Acid is trying to stay in the camera shot there while Lulu Lockjaw is avoiding it.
Lulu's like, I don't want to be on the camera.
Lead jammer, Sulfuric Acid.
Hot on her heels, Lulu Lockjaw is out.
Okay, this is about how many jammers or how many blockers going to be in. We have 3-2 blocker advantage. French Tickler and Blast Unicorn and Scrappy Gilluki trying to slow down. Debate to ride it.
Sulfuric Acid.
0-0. Wow. Great defense from Demanda Wright.
Seriously, she was running away. I really thought that Sulfuric Acid had that point on Demanda, but she did not.
Well, she has been reading up on her skills in bloodandthundermag.com. Blood and Thunder is the world's first and largest roller derby magazine. Find them at bloodandthundermag.com. That's why Demanda is as good as she does. She didn't even show up to practice. She just reads Blood and Thunder.
Never practices that Demanda Riot. Number 500, Ivy Profane. She shows up to practice.
Scald Eagle hops on the inside. Lead jammer blocker advantage for Rose City pays off here.
Yes, and Ivy Profane up the middle. Not lead jammer. She is out.
Well, you have an opportunity for one scoring pass. A fourth minor picked up by somebody. Not sure who. An opportunity for scoring pass, but it's not going to be enough for a lead change or any points at all, as it turns out.
Liza Machete is the one that picked up that fourth minor. I think she's going to be instructed to... Oh, she's going to sit down. We're going to have just two on the track.
Question mark two on the track, maybe. Question mark.
I saw Mr. Rock with his thumbs on his shoulders, which usually indicates that we are going to have an official timeout or official review here. The diamond shape with the hands.
Or he's doing his Fonzie impression. Hey! Or as Mr. Rock would say, hey!
That was actually a very good Rock.
I'll debut at After Party. I don't want to do my Rock impression too much on the feed.
And if you notice Rock is wearing sunglasses, it's because
he's cool. That's why.
It's because that California sunshine is streaming in here to the Craneway Pavilion, and it's a bit difficult. He does not want his vision to be skewed by the beautiful golden rays.
That's nice
coming
of you.
Off
he's
the
being
bay.
Cool.
Yeah, he is actually the cool guy in the sunglasses.
Yo, I like reffing with my sunglasses on.
I thought you weren't going to do it anymore.
I couldn't help it.
All right.
Randy, it helps me focus.
Again, incredible ref crew here. We're very lucky to have such amazing refs here at the Bay of Reckoning. I'm going to give them all a big high five at the after party because they deserve it.
And I really want you to consider the source, Miss Moxie, on
seriously
these ref compliments here.
I mean, and I've been saying it a lot, so you have to know that it is genuine. And around the outside, White Flight, lead jammer.
Picked up.
Chantilly Mace also out for Bay Area, not lead.
I think Frankenhardt picked up a multiplayer buck. I'm not 100% on that, though.
So we've got 3-on-2 here in the pack. Amanda Riot and Bell Riot hooks the only lines of defense. White Flight jukes around the outside. Man, she is quick. All 4 points there for Portland. White Flight.
Oh, my. It's a one-point.
It's a one-point game.
If you have feelings, share your feelings like everyone feeling does on the internet. Talk number two, WFTDA.com. It's how... everybody expresses their feelings.
This is how we do it in the 21st century.
Yeah.
On
not
Twitter.
In person.
No, on Twitter. Okay, we've got 2-on-2, I think. And
inside pass there for Sophia Gassett. She takes lead jammer with the quickness.
And it looks like we had a pile up there in turn one. Is going to allow Knock Knock to get out of the pack in the midst of all the madness. I think back block major is going to send Slavia Majora to the box.
I think there was.
Bay Area.
Oh, Havana, good time picking off Brawling Angel, opening up the opportunity for a scoring pass. That's going to be 4-0 and a lead chase. Rose City going up to 68, Bay Area 65.
And, you know, I think now it's Bay Area having a little bit of penalty trouble. Now we've got Shannon Dorado with 3 minutes in the box. Liza Machete with 2 minutes in the box. Slavia Majora with 2 minutes in the box. So they're catching up to Rose City on those penalties.
I want to apologize to the fans on behalf of Rose City and Bay Area for putting together such a boring bout for you.
Yeah, I know. Me and Randy should just put on some skates and get out there and play some announcer derby. What do you think, Randy?
As long as someone was beating us bloody, they would appreciate it. Lulu Lockjaw up against a two wall in front. Solid Eagle breaks free of the wall. Lead jammer, Solid Eagle.
And Amanda Riot trying to play a little offense for her girl there in the front, not having a whole lot of luck.
Oh, another multiplayer block.
They like to hang on to each other in Portland. Oh.
This is the fifth lead jam in a row for Rose City so far. Despite their blocker numbers, they are still getting out first and clean.
And juking her way to 4 points is Scald Eagle for Rose City. She's going to embiggen their lead. 72 points Rose City, 65 Bay Area.
Look it up. It's a word. Looks like Demanda Wright picked up a fourth minor, and Mercy going finally to the penalty box for her multiplayer earlier. And I know you, Moxie, would like to thank
Wicked Skatewear. They heart their sponsored leagues, Denver, Bay Area, Arizona, and Angel City. I heart Wicked Skatewear. Check them out, wickedskatewear.com.
I like how you're saying that.
It's, you know.
You're an entertainer.
A little bit of flair. I've got 15 pieces of flair.
Yeah. Or are you using all of your flair? Because it's only 15 recommended. Let's say official timeout there for stuff.
That gives us more time to talk about things and stuff, Randy.
Yes, let's talk about things and stuff, Miss Moxie. Psych, they're starting.
Okay. Ibuprofen jamming for Bay Area, number 500.
That's a White Flight jamming, and Ibuprofen outside gets the jammer.
Twinkle toes of Ibuprofen. You may not know, she is studying to be a doctor.
A doctor of kicking butt.
That's what she does. White Flight playing a little jammer on Jammer D. Not having a whole lot of luck getting hung up there on Brawling Angel there in the back of the pack.
How do you go seek going to the penalty box for stuff? And that is
five. Count. Five in the sky for Ibuprofen and Bay Area.
And set up for another scoring pass. So we see a very potential lead change here, Miss Moxie.
If she can stay on the floor.
Well, a lot more in white than in purple right now.
That's
so
true.
I think the odds are pretty good.
Bay Area Bell Ride Hooks trying to clear for some offense there for Ivy. She does a great job. One more grand slam for the Golden Girls. Change of lead. 75 points Bay Area, 72 Rose City. It looks like Bell Ride Hooks going to the box.
Oh, such a beautiful offensive block, too. Oh, look at that.
Five more points for Ivy. I didn't even see her go through.
That was an out-of-play call on Bell Ride Hooks. But it's where, oh, finally outside pass, inside juke pass, Christy Amagacha, initial pass for White Fly, able to stop the bleeding, but opportunity for one more scoring pass by Ibuprofen and all of her names. I don't even know them all.
If she can get by Mercy, she's thinking about it.
Mercy's like, there we go, there you go.
And she's going to call off the jam. All right, 19-point jam there for Ivy, bringing Bay Area's lead to 84. 72 for Rose City. OMG. Purveyors of the Derby Unusual. They're not crazy. They look just like Derby. Derbyology.com.
Got that Derbyology, the D-E-R-B-Y-O-L-O-G. Your Derby's palm next to me. I got the...
Yeah, Randy.
We just got a tweet that we're being sued by Paula Abdul. That's funny. Inside pass, sulfuric acid, much needed lead jammer for the Wheels of Jackpot.
Chantilly Mace also out, half a lap behind.
Of course she is. Whoa, look at all that purple on the track.
Yep, it looks like there's four Rose City blockers on the floor, only three for Bay Area. Amanda Riot sending sulfuric acid to the inside, protecting that last point. Only 3 points picked up there. But it's going to make a difference in this game of nickel and dimes, Randy Pan. That's 75 good. Points for Rose City, 84 Bay Area.
It's going to make it one nickel and five pennies with the Bay Area, 84 Rose City, 84, 75. I've been around you too long. I can't count no more. What are these numbers?
I'll rub off on you.
Oh, here's more numbers. 2-1 Skate Shop. Check out the Bracket Bonanza sponsor. 2-1 Skate Shop. Take 10% off your entire 2-1 Skate Shop eat.com when you use the coupon code Bonanza during the checkout.
All right. We have Scald Eagle against Knock Knock. Knock Knock headed to the floor, and Scald Eagle with just a couple Bay Area blockers there to get past.
Kid Ace with some great defense there on Scald Eagle.
Sugar Pusher lets her through. Lead jammer.
Inside lane there for Scald Eagle. Knock Knock just needs to get past Scrappy Go Lucky. Scrappy trying to escort with some great bridging. It's going to be an out of play on Scrappy Go Lucky. Just a bit outside. Scald Eagle like, what? I want the points.
I really love watching her skate.
It's a good
She time. Fights for every point. Picks up three.
I don't know if she passed one out of play or just did not get around Bell Right Hooks, which happens.
It does happen. She's on my home team, and I am so glad because getting around Bell Right Hooks is like, you just kind of have to hedge your bets.
I just recruited Bell Right Hooks to my home team. I don't want to mess with this. Derby for all experienced Derby skaters, getting you the right gear to take you to the next level. Mounting plates until Sunday morning at their mega booth. For all of you listening at home, you have a mere bout to get over here and get your plates mounted.
And we have a lead jammer, Ibuprofen for Bay Area, earning her keep here wearing that gold sparkly helmet.
Untamed Shrew. I believe this is only her second jam, but she does get her initial pass through. To stop the bleeding, Bay Area looking at extending their lead.
Just a little bit.
Oh.
She is right in that inside. A nice Bay Area PAC just basically escorted all of the Rose City blockers to the outside, effectively clearing that inside line for Ivy Profane, and she picked up 4 points.
You know what I love?
What?
Offense.
You know what I love is active offense, mm-hmm. and it's happening. On We're purpose. Watching it happen. Both They're teams. Doing it. They're On doing purpose. Stuff.
They're doing stuff. Tell them they're jammer through.
10-point lead by Bay Area.
You know who else does stuff?
Who Derbalife. Does stuff?
Derbalife is roller derby nutrition at its finest. Derbalife, doing stuff.
Their Spark Energy thing is so good. I use it for my, not Sparks, that's a different thing. Spark is so good. Sparks. I use it for energy, and it's great.
Nice. Okay, so we have sulfuric acid versus Chantilly Mace. Chantilly Mace out. Lead jammer, Bay Area.
I dare say the crowd goes wild.
The crowd is officially going wild.
Demanda Wright with an offensive block for sulfuric acid, which was very kind of her.
I don't think she meant to do that.
Yeah. She was like, get out of my way, I'm metal.
Chantilly Mace with a late call off. She picks up 4 points, but it looks like 2 points are picked up there by sulfuric acid. So just a point differential of 2 there. Making that gap for Bay Area 92 points to Rose City's 80. That's 12 points. I can do that math real fast.
You did really good because there's a Thank zero
you.
In there.
I get a gold star.
Yeah, so what's Skull Eagle's number 50 minus Knock Knock's 32?
I didn't say anything.
Did you?
I sort of, I went to the Bahamas.
The crickets?
I went to the Bahamas for a minute.
The
I'm
wind
sorry.
Going through your ears. Oh,
I'm
no.
back. I'm back, though. Yep. Okay, it looks like we are waiting just a minute. We have an official timeout.
Oh, wow. Look at these numbers right here. Bay Area with 18 penalty makes. Rose City with only 17. What this is saying with Bay Area's 12-point lead is that Bay Area is actually really doing good with execution in the second period.
And it looks like the Bay Area blocker with the most time in the box is Slabia Majora and Shannon Dorado. Both have 3 minutes in the box. French Tickler still holding strong with 4 minutes in the box for Rose City.
With 16 minutes left, those are actually good numbers.
They really are. 16 minutes left to go in this game, and Mr. Rock is still wearing sunglasses. Randy, you're wearing sunglasses.
Yeah.
It's kind of your thing.
It's kind of my thing. It's honestly to keep disguised, so people at cities that I announce at don't beat me up. Oh, look at how majestic Skull Eagle looks.
She does look very majestic. I like the eye makeup. You think she would do that on me?
I think she would.
Yeah? She seems nice.
Sometimes I have to edit myself. Garden State Roller Girls are watching. What's up, Garden State?
I'm assuming that's New Jersey.
I'm going with that.
Yeah, that's a good call, right?
I think that's...
Geographically wise.
I think that's Layla SmackDown's old league, I want to say. Or is it New Jersey Roller Girls? It might be a different one.
Anyway, hi, New Jersey.
Hi, New Jersey. I've been watching a lot of that
show. Oh, no,
show.
You didn't.
I did.
You just did.
I did.
Okay, so I'm not quite sure what this official review is reviewing, but I do know that it gives me a chance to tell you that if you want to talk directly to thousands of Derby fans, you should advertise on WFTDA.tv. They have affordable packages, and they're available for your business, boot camp, or tournament advertising. Visit WFTDA.com/sponsor opportunities to learn more.
You've got affordable packages. I don't know what that means.
You don't know.
Some deliberation going on. As of right now, we have a 4-2 blocker advantage on the track for Bay Area, which it puts them in a very comfortable position. But still 16 and a half minutes left.
Yeah, and you know they're going to take the opportunity to they're going to take this opportunity to field by they, I mean Rose City's field Scald Eagle, and number 32, Knock Knock, getting a back rub from...
Why is Daddy got to be yelling at Rock like that? I know, like,
Daddy
you
knows
are
things.
A thing of stuff.
You know, Daddy Decalicious was our tournament, our head tournament official for the Golden Bowl last year. She came up from Ventura. We heard Ventura County is watching.
I think Mr. Rock is going to make the official word.
And he's gonna
listen in on it really quick.
He's going to tell us what's going on. Anyway, Daddy Duck Delicious is amazing.
So he said, something else. Someone's in the box, and I don't know if the call was over 10 or not. So we're going to check in with Brad Example.
Yeah, you know, it's funny. I don't know if it's the microphone that they're giving the officials or if it's just the officials' voices, but all weekend long they've been notoriously difficult to hear. Knock Knock pushing through the front of that pack, trying to get that lead jammer nod, and she does for Bay Area. And we're back.
I gotta say, I saw that coming. Oh, wow, inside lane there for Scald Eagle. Good on her to stop the bleeding. We got a 3-2 pack advantage.
Knock
Quick
Knock
pass.
Picking up four, calling it off. And we've got 96 points, Bay Area. Rose City, 80 points.
So I translated Rock East to say that they were confirming that all the penalties that have been accrued have had time served.
I see.
So they're done the I's crossing the T's, making sure that everybody who did that crime has done the time.
And that's all you can do, really, you know, is just check and double check and triple check. I know everybody out here wants to do the best job that they can, the skaters, the officials, even us, Randy.
We even want to do good.
We're doing our best.
Oh, nice hit from White Flight, slowing down Ibuprofen.
White Flight doing double duty there as a jammer and a blocker. White Flight out, or I'm sorry, sulfuric acid out, and is your lead jammer Ibuprofen hot on her heels? Looks like sulfuric acid is going to want to try and slow Ivy down just a teeny tiny bit, or at least just keep her behind her.
Oh, we got both Rose City blockers standing right now. That's Blast Unicorn and Frankenherder. I like the discipline. I like the patience here, and it is really good for morale to clear the box. When you got a penalty go around, it is so good to just get everybody out there. More important than those points.
And I see Bay Area's Lulu Lockjaw, who picked up her intentional fourth minor. She was also sprung from the box, so it looks like, Randy, we're going to have 5-on-5. We're going to have 5-on-5 right now.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, no, I lied. Chantilly Mace taking her intentional fourth minor. They're picking this moment to do that. I think that's a wise decision.
We will have 5-on-5 for 1 second, and I will hold my breath for it. I can breathe again. Okay.
Okay, now we're back to 3 for Bay Area and 4 for Rose City. Lulu Lockjaw having a little bit of a tough time there with that nice, strong purple wall.
Back block call on
somebody. Oh, it looks like, I don't know.
4-on-call. Oh, a lot of minors, but inside pass, not lead jammer for Scald Eagle, so she's going to have to rely on her Rose City defense to hold off Lulu Lockjaw. They're doing pretty good so far. 4-2
yeah.
Blocker advantage.
Pretty good so far. Oh, Brawling Angel with a swing and a miss, trying to get Lulu out.
A swing and a miss in the wrong direction. Quick outside pass by Scald Eagle, put in a very needed, let's count it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points on the board for Rose City.
I believe it's 5. Bay Area with a blocker disadvantage now. They've only got 2 out there, and that means Lulu Lockjaw is going to be left to her own devices there at the front of the pack.
Some fancy bridging going on. Out of play called by Brawling Angel. 4-1 blocker advantage. Here's a question, Moxie. You got a 4-1 or a 4-2.
Uh-huh.
Do you match points, go for an extra point, or do you call off the jam and start again?
Well, you know, at this...
Never mind.
Yeah, exactly.
It's grab and go, like he's going to the penalty box. What? So...
And at this juncture, we don't have a lead jammer, I think, is why no one's calling off the jam,
that's
Randy.
Right. That's right. Yeah. Sorry about that. I got all ahead of myself. Fourth minor picked up somewhere on someone somehow.
Chantilly Mace trying to play a little bit of offense or a defense there on Scald Eagle. She is a jammer usually, but as we know, she was picking up her intentional fourth minor, so she's on the track now as a blocker.
Now, Lulu Lockjaw is still in her initial pass. Am I correct here, Miss Monty?
I believe she is.
Yes, I have it confirmed by the very, very smart bright example. She just has Mel Mangles to get past. That's easier said than done.
And she did. She did. She is out. She finally picks up lead, calls it off. 2 more points picked up there by Scald Eagle.
Oh, well, you did have a scoring pass
we
there.
We did have a scoring pass, yeah.
Lulu Lockjaw. So we're going to have points there. That's going to be 100 Bay Area, Rose City 96. Now, great jam for Rose City, but it did land a couple of blockers in the penalty box, so I don't know if this will have a net effect for them, but it's good to be in single digits.
It's true. It's true.
You know what also is
yeah,
good?
4-point game. 12 minutes left to play. The clock is running. And I heard a whistle.
Fivestride.com. Online.
And
in store.
in the city that never sleeps, owned by Bonnie Thunders, OMG, WTF. Yeah, they wanted to give us a chance to give a shout-out to Five Stride.
Yes.
Appreciate it, ladies.
Bay Area wanted to get Brawling Angel out of the box, so now there's a 4-2 blocker advantage in favor of Bay Area. Knock Knock is going to try and get past those two Rose City blockers.
Dude, Knock Knock probably going to do it. Probably yeah. does. Heidi's going to get a blocking out of play.
Yeah, that's a little bit rough.
That's a little, that desperation coming into Rose City. They need to take some deep breaths right now because they cannot afford those penalties, not at this time and not with the score standing where it is.
And you know what, Randy? I like to say there's a two-stride rule. If you take two steps to catch that jammer at the front of the pack, that's all you got. You take more than that, and you're probably going to be out of play. Yeah. So she took, I think, four steps.
She took six, seven. Ithaca League of Women. Rollers listening. How you doing, Ithaca? Thanks for joining us.
It's cool. We're making it rain here at the Craneway Pavilion.
Rain sponsors and tweets.
And it looks like Knock Knock picking up four more points, so a nine point jam there. 109 Bay Area, 96 Rose City, and also putting another Rose City blocker in the box. So
my. So 13 points. When you are telling me what math is.
I know, that's sad. That's a sad day. The crowd giving it up for their hometown league, Bay Area.
We got 30, now 10 minutes left. It's easy to get 13 points in 10 minutes, but what has to happen is Rose City getting out of their penalty box trouble. It's really hurting them right now. They have opportunities to score and run, but not with all their players in the penalty box, especially with Bay Area doing a great job keeping their skaters out there.
And, you know, I haven't seen J.K. Rowling with a jammer star on this game, so it looks like they may be in a little bit of jammer penalty trouble right
now. Might be. A lot of people sitting on three and if they're sitting on three and they going out with two blockers, you cannot afford to poodle at that time. It's
exactly.
Just not going to do you any good.
Yeah, you need all the defensive help on the track that you can get.
I like putting JK out there. She is a great utility player. Offense, defense, jammer. She can do it all, and she can execute very well. Rose City with 23 minutes in the box. Bay Area with 19.
And that's number 500, Ivy Profane, jamming for Bay Area. It looks like Lulu Lockjaw is going to take her intentional fourth minor.
It looks like she's getting her picture taken. So it looks like she's like, what? Check me out. Ivy Profane navigating that front wall. JK getting cycled to the back by Demanda Riot.
And she is going to pick up lead jammer Lulu Lockjaw. I'm sorry, Ivy Profane for Bay Area. Yeah.
Rose City trying to go offense there, but they've already set up for Ivy Profane scoring pass. JK Rowling getting her initial pass there. No points yet. Another jam.
And Demanda Riot sending two blockers to the outside. Ivy picking up 4 points, 5 points. Because she did get that fifth point on JK Rowling before JK Rowling got out of the pack. So we do have a 5 point pass there by Bay Area.
She sure did.
I'm starting to not be able to talk, Randy. It must be 9 minutes and 30 seconds left.
It must be Bay Area 114 and Rose City 96. 18-point lead there for Bay Area. 3-2 pack advantage for Bay Area. Chantilly Mace, 26 for Bay Area. Sulfuric Acid for Rose City.
I like that Rose City has their names on their jerseys so I can tell what's happening with them.
Yeah, and like Chantilly every Mace. Other sport in the world. Oh, sorry. Yeah.
Chantilly Mace picking up lead jammer very quickly for Bay Area.
Well, they got numbers in their favor and not a lot of blockers out there for Rose City. Wow, quick pass around the outside for Chantilly Mace. Finally, Sulfuric Acid gets out. Chantilly Mace going to eat the baby, which is when one jammer stuffs another jammer back into the pack. But Sulfuric Acid doesn't like to be eaten.
No, and Chantilly Mace saw her fourth blocker come out of the box, and she says, okay, now's a good time. I picked up 5 points, and I have all my blockers. I'm going to call off the jam.
Ermager, Desmer, Heidi Go Seek, Mel Mangles, and French Tickler now sitting on four penalties in 8.5 minutes. It's still a lot, though.
S1 helmets make the safest and best helmets for roller derby. Check them out at s1helmets.com.
There's no helmets like the safest and bestest.
Safest and bestest. Small-inating and embiggening. All right, so we have Knock Knock jamming for Bay Area.
Speaking of embiggening, oh my goodness, J.K. Rowling, go to the penalty box.
Knock Knock lead jammer for Bay Area. White Flight for Rose City, still trapped in the back of the pack, sent to the outside by Brawling Angel. She didn't quite get her out. Easy 5 points there for Knock Knock. Not even a glance, I don't think.
So Mercy and Heidi Go Seek trying to pick one off to get a White Flight a initial pass here.
And it looks like Knock Knock trying to make another scoring pass.
Here's the key here for Rose City. Don't do anything desperate when the Barry Jammer hits. You're just going to keep going. A little more control there. Gave up a four-point scoring pass, but it's worth.
Yes, it's worth getting
not
your blockers.
Going to the penalty box.
Not going, yeah, and getting your blockers out of the box, honestly. Like.
We got 128 Bay Area, Rose City 96. That's a 32-point lead there with 7 minutes and change. Plenty of time to turn this around for Rose City.
Absolutely.
Providing they clear the penalty.
And I think they're going to do it, Randy. I think they're going to do it. Sulfuric acid taking the line for Rose City. Ibuprofen jamming for Bay Area. She tries to take that outside line but is denied by Mercy. And there's sulfuric acid running up the inside. She's going to pick up lead jammer for Rose City.
That is bananas. 4-2 blocker advantage, and sulfuric acid still gets lead jammer. Mercy with some great one-on-one defense up the front, holding ibuprofen in.
She does an incredible job.
My goodness. Takes a spill there. Looks incidental.
Yeah.
Amanda's like, I'm going to get you out of the way, Mercy.
And she's not having any luck so far.
That's how
that
she
pack
talks.
Is flying around. It's not a diamond. That's how you skate it, though.
The track. Slowing down there. Out of play. Finally given. Wisely.
Yes.
Give up that initial pass there and go offense there. Get your jammer some points while you can.
And stop the bleeding there, hopefully.
JK catches and the scoring pass is going on.
It looks like we're going to have
4-3.
3 points for Rose City. 4 points picked up by Bay Area.
Little late on the call off there, but one less blocker in the box for Rose City.
Yeah, it looks like they're 3-on-4. Two? No, they still got two.
33-point lead, 5:40. It is clicking. The clock is ticking. The clock is definitely favoring Bay Area. But as we saw in the Sacred City, Angel City bout earlier, well within reach.
Well within reach. And White Flight has her game face on. So does Bell Right Hook. So does Brawlin' Angel. Liza so Machete up front trying to play a little offense for Lulu Lockjaw.
You got to be careful. That's going to get an out of play in the back. Now out of play in front. That's going to be a back block major on Lulu Lockjaw. This is exactly what Rose City need right now.
They do. They just need to get White Flight.
They also need some
pass.
Offense.
Yes, they do.
They need lead jammer. They need offense. They need blockers on track. They need all of the things.
All of the things. All of the people, and they need all of the points. They need 33 points, to be exact, to tie this game.
This is incredible defense being played by Bay Area right now, as they're instructed by the crowd
the
right
crowd
now.
The crowd is chanting defense, so in case Bay Area did not know what to do at this juncture, they're being told by the crowd.
I can't say I disagree. Okay, there is one more to pass for White Flight. Gets out. Calls it off. I believe the intention is to ice the jammer and start with a blocker advantage.
They definitely are going to start with a blocker advantage. Bay Area saw two of their blockers go to the box during that power jam. Now the tables have turned. Coach G Money has some things that he wants to say about that to his skaters that are on the track right now.
All right, this is huge. With 4 minutes left, this is huge for Rose City right now. Sulfuric acid. 4-2 blocker advantage. All right, outside lane being trying to picked up by J.K. Rowland. Nice defense up front by Demanda Riot. And Dorado, initial pass.
They have to let her go. It looks like.
Mercy going to the penalty box. And Rose City having a hard time slowing down the pack. That's helping out Bay Area.
Slowly slowing down, though. I don't know that Demanda Riot and Shannon Dorado are aware that they don't have a whole lot of space to work with here unless they're going to get that out of play.
Lulu Lockjaw back into play. Initial pass hit to the inside by Frankenherter. There's 5 points there. It is getting really tense in here right now, Miss Moxie.
It is.
Woo!
Rose City really putting it on.
Oh, there's a quick outside pass there for 5 more points. That's going to bring it down to a 23-point lead.
Ooh, Lockjaw kind of looks like she's a little bit out of gas.
All right, another scoring pass. Is it 5? Yes, it is. 18-point lead by Bay Area right now, 132 to 114. We got 44 seconds on the clock here, or on the jam clock. An initial pass finally made for Lulu Lockjaw.
And Amanda Riott with a hit on sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid says, I'm going to call this jam now.
Did she get any points out of that?
0-0.
Wow. I would have pushed for one more pass or at least a couple more points before. Not a lot of time right now. Rose City with 2 timeouts.
Bay Area also with 2 timeouts.
18-point lead. Time on Bay Area's side. This is going to come down to lead jammer.
I believe that it will. And either of these ladies, White Flight or Chantilly Mace, can make that happen.
Scald Eagle picking an intentional fourth minor. We got all three of the rest of the Rose City blockers in. But right hooks with a hit to the outside. White Flight, lead jammer, Rose City. This is huge for them. This is super important for them. And, well, you know, thank both these teams for making this game fun for you at home. Watch WFDA.TV. Big hit from Havana Good Time to Chantilly Mace to the outside, Miss Moxie.
And we're just not playing any defense there. They're just allowing 5 points there to be picked up by White Flight. Chantilly Mace is out of the pack.
Okay.
Effectively stopping the bleeding here.
Yeah,
but
that's,
we do have one more scoring pass here that White Flight is about to make.
She's got to be careful with it. She's also got to not go to the penalty box.
Yeah.
I don't think any points happened on that one. No, they didn't. You can bet a timeout's going to be called by Rob Lobster. It is.
Okay, we
13 points. Okay. Remember, do you remember, Miss Moxie?
The time that I had a heart attack and an aneurysm at the same time?
Do you remember when going to champs came down to lead jammer? Do you remember when we had a 4-3?
You know what I do remember, Randy? I remember the last 3 years. Rose City and Bay Area fighting for that number 3 spot.
Yep.
This has happened. This is the third year in a row. It happened in 2011, 2010, and 2009. Rose City and Bay Area fighting for that, and they've traded off.
Yeah, we're getting some complaints about how not fun this game is from people that are stupid, and we're going to cut. So, Bay Area in a good position here. They got a 4-3 blocker advantage. You got Knock Knock, who just is killer with getting lead jammer. Now, Sulfuric Acid, also very good at getting lead jammer. Intensity in 10 cities. Rose City are going to have to play this perfectly. They're going to have to get lead jammer.
And they're going to have to keep Knock Knock in or send her to the box.
Yeah. If Knock Knock gets to the box, it's a great opportunity. If not, hit it, quit it one time, and then probably have to stop. I don't know how to play this.
Seriously, Randy, if I have a heart attack and I die, tell my parents I love them. Knock Knock, lead jammer, Bay Area.
Now, Knock Knock doing exactly the right thing here. G-Money telling her to slow the roll. Time is on her side. Make it go. Sulfuric Acid running to get the points. You know Rose City have to slow down the pack to give her these scoring opportunities.
Knock Knock got 1 point. We've got 31 seconds left on the clock.
Bay Area in good positioning here. Key for Bay Area. Knock Knock, don't go to the box.
Very key. Like, so key, I can't even tell you how key that is.
The most key. Both navigating. I hear a call somewhere.
Yep,
that's from Rock, so it's going to be on someone in the pack.
Okay. 12 seconds left.
A low block being called. Wow. Oh, my gosh. It's coming down to the wire.
Knock Knock is standing still. She's watching the clock. She's calling off the jam.
Calling off the jam.
Ladies and gentlemen.
2-2. Ladies and gentlemen. What a bout. It looks like Bay Area's taking it. The number 3 spot to go to championships, Miss Moxie.
I'm having a little bit of a hard time here, Randy. These ladies have worked super hard all season. It's so nice to be able to do this at home. As you can see, the Golden Girls are very proud. We're going to Atlanta.
Rose City coming out with a very hard-fought battle. Working out, come in the number one seed. And Bay Area in the number four seed comes in and wins their first spot at championships in, is it 2 or 3 years?
They went in 2010. You
2010,
know, fun
yes,
fact,
2 years.
Fun fact, Randy Pan, the Bay Area has gone to championships in every even-numbered year. They went in 2008, 2010, and now 2012.
It is their year. Rose City, Bay Area, what a great bout. What a hard-fought bout. 12 points. Man, 135 Bay Area, 123 Rose City. Bay Area taking their victory lap.
And
incredible,
the crowd goes
work for
wild.
Them. And you know what? This is the credit that Bay Area deserves. They stayed on the track.
They did.
Penalties being an issue for them for so long, they stayed on the track. They did the work, earned their spot. Great play for them. Rose City taking their lap, their consolation lap. I'm so proud of these girls. I'm so proud of the work they've done. Such a hard region to perform in. Rough start to the weekend. They really played a great bout here, so this is a beautiful bout to go on.
It is, and you know, Rose City, so commendable. They looked incredible out there, and Bay Area, you know, formidable opponents. This was an incredible bout. I couldn't have been prouder. It looks like this was a game based on who was in the box. Bay Area with 21 penalty minutes, Rose City with 30. And that has made all the difference.
21 penalty minutes, that's like an A-plus in Derby. Only 20 minutes in the box that you made penalties an advantage. And, wow, good on them. They always had a high-execution team, but they made the one big adjustment they've always needed to make, stay on the track. And they got into them last night. They didn't let it be a problem today. And they're going to championships, Miss Moxie.
It's true. You know, I think, Randy, last night I walked out to my car to find the Bay Area Derby girls ice bathing in a kiddie pool in the parking lot, listening to, of all things, Ani DeFranco. But this team has worked
I knew that team.
So hard together. That was Demander Riot. So hard together all season long. They ice bath together, and you know, they're reaping the benefits of all of that hard work. It has paid off. They will take that third seed and a ticket to championships. And I'm watching Coach G Money. He looks very proud.
So, ladies and gentlemen, you've heard it. The key, ice baths. Okay,
ice baths.
I didn't see that coming. Ice baths, very, very important to Derby success.
Yes, I have also ice bathed once with the team. I don't think I'm ever going to do it again. Also, Coach G Money said if we go to championships, he's going to ice bath with the team for the rest of the season. He's going to have to eat his words. That is some cold water.
I want pictures, Moxie.
Okay, pictures or it didn't happen.
It'll the world wants
I'll
pictures.
Tweet it. I'll tweet picture. It to you.
You can tweet it. We've been getting so many tweets from all the exciting tweeting out there in Tweetland. All righty.
I think.
That's it, Avery.
Yeah, no.
I think
I'm
just going to close this out. What about congratulations to the Bay Area Derby girls for the
extent.
It was just such a great bout.
It was amazing bout. And I'm going to watch it again and again and again after I buy the DVDs. And, you know, now if you'll excuse me, I need to go drink a beer and buy my ticket to Atlanta for championships.
I'm going to tell you to go to WFDDA.com/MVP to vote for your MVPs. Get your brackets in. We're going to check back in just a moment. I think we have 40 minutes on the clock. We're going to try to get rid of the sun here for a little bit. We're going to come into the championship bout. Holy Rollers versus Denver Roller Dolls. What do you think, Moxie?
I think that I'm going to go say some words on the side of the track. That's what I think.
I think it's going to be an exciting high execution bout. So stay tuned. Check in with that. We'll check in just a bit. Randy Pan.
Miss Moxie. High five, Randy.
Five.
We'll see you later.
Good call.
You can never have too many roller derby t-shirts. Now you can get a new one every month from a league from around the world. Just join the Roller Derby Shirt Club. And while you're at it, sign up your derby wire.
Since 2006, Blood and Thunder Magazine has been covering your favorite sport. Find out where to get it by going to bloodandthundermag.com. And find out the latest developments of the next World Cup at rollerderbyworldcup.com.
Brenda Gold, and I've been at Riddell for 36 years almost. Everything is done by hand, basically. Just a one pair actually going through at a time then. And some of them are multiple colors where it'll have 5-6 colors, metallics, the different colored full grains, you name it. Some of them are pretty wild. To me, the skaters are really important because that's what keeps us going here. It's the consumer or the skater that decides, okay, is it good enough for me or not? We want them to be happy, that's for sure.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Brad Example for WFTDA.TV. I'm here with Chantilly Mace, number 26, from the Bay Area Derby Girls. You just beat Rose City 135-123. You're going to championships. How hard did you guys work to get this?
This has been an incredible season. We have worked our whole season with really this goal in mind. We went 2 years ago, and we didn't get as far as we want. And this year, our goal is to make it to Sunday.
One significant factor in your victory here was you guys had noticeably fewer penalty minutes than the other team. Has that been a priority for you?
Yes, we've done a lot of penalty tracking and analysis throughout the season, knowing that the team that stays on the floor can execute their strategy and really put it into action when it counts.
So now in Atlanta, first weekend of November, you're going to be facing the top three finishers from across the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. How do you prepare for that event?
Well, I think it'll be pretty much like we prepared for this. A lot of hard work, a lot of focus, and a lot of being consistent and strategic about the opponents that we'll face and the strengths and weaknesses that they have that we can execute against.
All right, so number three finishers at the West Region Tournament, the Bay Area Derby Girls, joining the Denver Roller Dolls and the Ole Rollers, advancing to the championships for 2012. With Chantilly Mace, number 26 from Bay Area, this is Brad Example for WFTDA.TV.